Hi everyone, Vivekanandam welcomes you all once again for the social science class for the grade 6 from Appa Public School. Today, before starting our lesson, I want to show to you something so that you can recognize what I am going to teach you. So this is, what is this? Yes, exactly. Everyone knows this is a computer. Very good. And what is this? This is a cell phone. And this is a computer. What this era is called technology area. We are using the technology. The computer as well as cell phones, we are using for the communication purpose. For the sake of communication purpose, for communication purpose, we are using the computers as well as the cell phones, right? Why we are using these computers and cell phones? To know, by sitting at one particular place, we can move around the world, and whatever the information you want, you collect it. Yeah, absolutely. What I'm telling you is your computer class like that only. And through the computer, when you're going to Google's or Gmail, there you can find out, there you can search. Like previously when I taught the geography lesson, about on the lessons, how many continents are there on the globe, where is India is located, all sort of information, how many states are there in India, how many districts are there in Karnataka, all you learn. Because the technology, the information, the communication plays an important role nowadays. Imagine if computer is not there, cell phones are not there, then how we are going to communicate with each other? The communication point of view. You just go back to 50 years, what happens? See the difference between the village and the city. Now we are staying in Kalburgi. We have a lot of all sort of facilities are available. If you focus in the village, still some facilities are lacking. Okay, if you take 100 years back, what happens? We are all came from the village to city, right? Rural place to urban place to get the better development, to get the better facilities. That is called migration. Right? Once again, I want to take you to this computer era or cell phone era. See, if mother and father are preparing very good food in the home, but you don't like, they really eating the same food, what do you do? Now, apart from the home, we have the food facilities from outsources. That is called through the dot-coms. We have Swiggy.com, Zomato, Amazon, and all these things, within a half an hour of ordering, your material or your food will reach to you. And not only that, if you see the pizza also is a food, favorite food now become food of pizza as well as the noodles. And pizza is challenging if we are unable to serve within half an hour, if our food is not reaching to you, within half an hour, the whatever you order, it will be free of cost to you. This is what, this is the food. Now in the computer, in the system, they are giving the food. They are challenging. Yeah, all type of foods are available within half an hour. After reaching, that food will reach to you. Right? So these are the communication purpose. And I asked you to go back to 100 years. And if we started 20 lakhs years back, 2 million years back, if you think about what happens. Now, for the cutting the apple, what we are doing, we are using the knife. Then our friends, the old man, the science says the man has come from the chimpanzee or monkey. And for the communication purpose, now we learn how to use the computer, everything. But in this particular, this 2000 lakhs years ago, what happens? How would the people have made communication 20 lakhs years ago? What happened? The question, how the people have survived? How they survive or how they live? How they live is a question. Now this is the answer. Can you see this? The tools. These are the tools. Now you see by this tools which are made up of stones, and think about the knife. And this picture also told how these people of early 2 lakh years, they used this system. How they used. See here. Here it is. The tools they used. The tools made with the, this is the stone and this is wood. Like hammer today, we are using the same model, but here the tools are very different. Lot of tools, you can observe it, lot of tools are used with the stone and wood. So, with the stone and wood, how the people survived, what they did to live, to eat, what they done it. Once again, I want to take you to the difference between two particular eras. This is computer era and this is the old year eras. See, the man, even he don't have proper clothes to wear. The man is wear only upper part, is not wear anything. You can see beside a river, bank of the river, they stay. They heard the cow, buffaloes, animals, they survive. And see the raw meat, the lady who is, the cooking style also is different in those days. And the man who is preparing the tools, how he is preparing the tools? He is preparing the tools with the stones. So this is the picture how the man is survived in those days. He don't have communication. He don't have computers like this, like us. So instead of computer, now he is having all sort of families are staying together, and he is staying in a forest. In that forest, he has to fight with the animals, right? With the wild animals. So here, he has to fight with the wild animals. To save himself, entire his family has to stay, in the forest for that particular reason. What he has to do? He has to protect himself from the wild animals as well as animals also he has to save. He has to save his family and his domestic animals. Domestic animals and family has to be saved from the wild animals. Wild animals means the very cruel animals which can kill, like a tiger, lion, elephant. These are comes under the wild animals. And the domestic animals like cow, dog, sheep, goat, hen. All these things, animals, he has to, along with his family, he has to save. For that, he has to use the tools, like this type of tools they use to protect himself and to protect themselves. Here, this type of tools they use to fight, to protect, to kill, and to prey. Prey means kill, like a deer, hen, pigs, and other animals. They used to catch hold of them and they can eat. But this, now the question is arise, how the man is survived without the food, whether he had the food or not, is the question. Yes, definitely the man will live, man cannot live without a water or without the food. In those days also they had food, now also we are having the food. But difference is there that we are having the delicious food. In those days, they used to have raw food, the food which is not cooked. You know, today very less people are having the raw foods like carrot, radish. But in those days, instead of man cooking, he don't know how to cook. He don't know how to cook. In the early stage, why he don't know how to cook is, he was saying, to first of all, we see today in our city, we can see the houses. How many types of houses are there? Kaccha house, pakka house, buildings, multi-store buildings, multi-store buildings. So like this, today we have houses. What is the purpose of houses? Houses are there to protect ourselves. Houses are there to protect ourselves from the animals, from the rain, from the heat, from the cold, or thieves. Right? This is the purpose. Today we have constructing the houses in the society. And why we are not living in the rural areas or village areas, we are coming to city life to have a good facilities, like a bus facility, like hospitals, like a trains, like a markets, malls, all facilities where are available, there the man is having this one. He has set up himself, he has settled, yes, to settle himself, to have a good facilities to protect and to have good life, to live the better life. To live the better life, the man is shifting. Then what about in the olden days? What about in the olden days where they live, how they live, and what they have? Now, 2 lakh years ago, how the man is, where they live? He lived caves, like in Maharashtra, Ajanta and Ellora caves are there. In those days, instead of man don't know how to build the houses, they already which was there, they made and they stayed in the caves. and from there he feels very safety from the wild animals and rocks. He stayed in the rocks. This is the houses of old man. And the third one is, and they made trees. On the tree they made their shelter. Like a bird, how they are living. On this, these three things, they made the houses, caves, rocks, and trees. This is what, okay, he has stayed, he has protected. He is protected from his family, from the wild animals or other animals to come, like a snake and other thing which is come in the night to kill. All these things to make a safety of that particular period, they made it. Next, then after making the shelter or house for themselves, what is the next one is about, he don't know how to cook. What is eating habits? What is eating habits? What they eat, what they ate. What they ate. Today we are eating all sort of fruits. Fruits like apple, banana, chiku, mango. As for the seasons, we are eating like a mango is a summer fruit, special fruit. Very tasty fruit. But in olden days, what the man they eat, they eat the fruits. They eat the fruits which is available in the forest. If you see the forest, then you can see honeycomb, which is made by honeybee. Very tasty, very sweet. And even today also, some of the people are using for medicine purpose also, the original honey. And like fruits, which is on the trees, and they even ate the stem and roots also, they ate the stem, roots on this thing. Now, example of roots is sweet potato. Oblique potato. Potato. All these things the man has, he had all the fruits without creating them or without making any work. But apart from this, if he wants to eat the meat, what he has to do? If he wants to eat, what he has to do? Yeah. What he has to do here, all things are available by nature. God has created, the man is going there according to the seasons. He's having the fruits. On the trees, whatever on the stem, on the roots, whatever things are available according to the seasons, he's having. But apart from these fruits, if he wants to have that meat, he has to hunt. Hunter. That is what my lesson is. Today's my lesson is from hunting, gathering, growing. How man has eaten, how they have made the food available from the animals, how they protected themselves, where they live, and to wear like a dress. Today we are wearing the Western style dresses. But in those days, once again you see the picture, the man is not wore any dress here. Here the man who is standing there, there is no proper dress, only cover the lower body with the animal's skin. That is what? The man is hunted and gathered a food hunting and gathering, they grow their fruit. And this one about the meat, about the boat, you know, how to hunt and how to make the and boat and fishing in the pond and in the river. And to protect his house, he made dog also as a best friend. Dog is a good, faithful animal to us. In everywhere, almost every city, the people have avoided the dogs. The domestic animals are there. They rear the dogs to protect their houses. But apart from this, okay, man is there, he's fishing, is eating the fishing, a river is there, and pond is there. Continuously, if he is keep on catching the fish in the this particular two places, what happens? One day, all the things, all the fishes on the particular river or pond will finish, and there is nothing. That time, what the man has to do, he has to move from one place to another. He has to leave the one place to another. What do you call that, moving from one place to another? Why? What is the reason? First of all, why he has to move from one place to another to have the better facilities, the better food, and protect from them? Or according to the season, he has to leave. In this chapter, if you see the example of fishing, fishing from the river, from the pond, continuously keep on fishing, one day the fishes may not be there on the particular place. And what he has to do to catch hold of the other fishes, he has to move. That moving from one place to another is called migration. Migration. Moving from one place to another for the better development, for the better facilities, for the better food, to protect better facilities, we are saying that migration. For example, starting from the Jammu Kashmir, where two places, Jammu and Kashmir, we have the two capitals. One is Jammu, one is Kashmir. Every 6 months they use it. According to the seasons, in the winter season, you have to leave that place. All in the winter place, in the winter time, all the snow will cover. And the man doesn't even to have anything. Even trees, plants, everything will cover with the snow. And when the summer comes, the snow will start melting it. That time, the people will move from one place to another. That's called migration. Who will move? Man will move. Man will go for migration. Man, animals, and birds will move from one place to another. That is called migration. Man, animals, and birds will move from one place to another. That is called migration. You can ask the question, sir, why we have to live from one particular, why can't we stay? If you are staying continuously one particular area, the man is depending purely on the trees and the fruits. He is continuously depending on the trees and the fruits. If the fruits and other things are available according to the seasons. And example I showed about the mango. If man is depend purely on the mango, eating everything and preparing the food with the mango delicious, with the mango, this thing with the pickles or juice, everything they are making with the mango. Here, they keep on continuing according to the seasons. Seasons he has to leave. After summer, now mangoes will not available. Then you have to go to new places. Like this, the man has to move from one place to another to protect. And regarding this meat, fishing, in those days, about the particular 2 lakh years ago, man used to have raw meat. Raw. which is not cooked. Normally, removing the skin of the goat, removing the skin of the hen, removing the skin of the deer, and everyone is sharing, the family members are sharing. And unfortunately, one particular day, what happened? How the man came to know that raw material, raw food is not tastier than the cooked food. We are using the food which is today cooking the food. We are cooking the food. You can see if you focus in the kitchen, your mommy will prepare, your mother will prepare. Prepare the food by using the cookers. Cooker will take very less time to cook the food. But in those days, cookers were not available. Even they don't know how to get fire, how to prepare. But unfortunately, one day the deer got fire. The dead body of the deer, when they hunting, it has got injured and died, and he fell down into the fire. And after that, after 20-30 minutes, the body of this animal got fried. And the man started eating. They were hungry, they ate, and they found different taste. And that onwards, they learned that raw material, raw food is not tasty than the cooked food. And after that, the man, he started cooking the food. We can see in the picture, the lady is cooking the food with the help of the fire, but she is not using any utensils. Only three bamboos are there, the dead body, the body of the goat, it was lying on the fire. The woman has keep on putting the fire so that this meat will get steam and it will get cooked. In this way, the man started eating the cook. But after eating, how to eat? With the help of this one, they made eating. And apart from eating the meat of the cook, then he learned also about the agriculture. He learned about the agriculture. How we to make a field to make ready for the next crop, what he has to do? To make the next crop for this thing, he has to dig. He has to dig the holes. How the man has dig? One more question. For the field, how the man is dig? For that, today, we are using the tractors. Latest technology. As I told you in the beginning, we are living in the computer era. We are living in the smartphone area, where whatever you want within the fraction of seconds is available. But as for this man, what he has done it? How this man, the man who is making the tools here, can see the man is making the tools with the help of the stones. Different kind of stones are there in front of him. And for the digging purpose, he made different type of tools with the stone. So here is a sharp tool which is made up of stone. Here he is digging. You can see he is digging the field so that he can sow the seeds, or like he can available whatever the roots or stem is available, he can utilize it. Right here, the man is using the different type of tools for digging. This is made up of the stone tools. And next picture is showing about the man is making the clothes with the animal skin. The man is making the close to protect himself from the heat, winter, summer, rainy season, with the help of the different tool. You can see the different tools. One is for digging, the other one is to cut the skin of the animals and to wear it, to protect himself as a, today we are using as a clothes. But in those days, the technology was not available. The man doesn't know how to use all these things. The existing tools are available about the stone only. He made different shapes of the tools and they used it. In this way, the man, how they gathered, how they hunted, and how they lived, why they lived, if they lived really, what happens? Apart from this, even they, apart from this goat, hen also, even he caught hold of the birds. He ate the birds also. And roots and nuts. Today we are eating other peanuts. Nuts, all these things, apart from these animals, fishing, all fish, all these things, he has used it. But when the time has changed, he has to come by learning year by year. One era is completed, the other era we go. They have learned, so many things has been learned to have the better development of their feasting. If you see once again, you can imagine the man having those days also having their own technology and using the tools which is made up of with the stone. And these tools are different from these tools. And in this CBSE book, they mention here about the purpose of the tool digging. Purpose here, to cut the skin to make the dress. So in this way, now you came to know the difference between the man is remained same, but the technology is changed. In those days, he don't know how to cook. But unfortunately, that because of that God, by instantly the deer got fire. Then he had, and here he came to know the different taste. And after some years, he started how to grow the foods because of migration. The key plant continuously they are migrating. Apart from this migration, the people who have been living, they made the best friends already about the few animals to make the business, to get the facilities from the animals, food saved for the future purpose. For the sake of the future purpose, man has saved the animals like goat, deer, animal. It is like every time, whenever they want, they can cut and they can have this. So in this production, in this era, the man is learned how to grow the fruit. For that purpose, not only for the migration, one more comes first migration. In the migration, there are two important things you have to note down, is that one is about the food, the second one is place, the third one is about, today in Hindi we are calling them roti kapda aur makan, roti kapda aur makan. In English it is called food, shelter and clothing. For that particular purpose, what the man has done, where he has lived, from where he learned, all these things, we will learn in the next lesson. Thank you. Thank you.